Hello, I'm Dave Kessler, and I'm going to talk to you about model-based clustering with PROC MBC. First, what is PROC MBC? PROC MBC is a SAS procedure that gives you an interface to a set of SAS Viya actions. These actions implement mixtures of multivariate Gaussian and uniform distributions. The goal is model-based clustering, which is what MBC stands for. The procedure is the front end or interface to the actions. The actions perform all the computations. PROC MBC and its actions are available in SAS Visual Statistics. Because the actions run on SAS Viya, they can take advantage of the available computing resources to parallelize computations. Now, what is clustering? Very simply, it's grouping similar items together. Deciding which items are similar to each other depends on the clustering method, and many clustering methods use the straight line or Euclidean distance to decide how similar two items are. You understand clustering, but what is model-based clustering? In model-based clustering, the likelihood is the basis for similarity. The likelihood comes from a finite mixture model. A finite mixture model has mixture components, and these mixture components represent the clusters. This all sounds interesting, but why use model-based clustering? Model-based clustering is based on a likelihood, so you can use well-established statistical methods for model selection. Also, the clustering can be soft. This means that each clustering has a measure of strength rather than being a rigid classification. Finally, the form of each mixture component can vary in shape from the others, meaning that you do not need to be restricted to one cluster shape. What does model-based clustering look like? Here's an example. You see two clusters where there is strong correlation within each cluster. That is the X shape. You also see some points outside the clusters, which represent some amount of background noise. If you use a traditional clustering method like k-means, what will happen? K-means quickly does what it was built to do. The shape and color of the marker indicates the cluster to which k-means assigned that point, and the dark markers indicate the center of the different clusters. The challenge here is that k-means is designed to find the best circular clusters in the data, and the clusters you see are clearly not circular. Now let's see how model-based clustering approaches this problem. First, look at the model. Here is the general mixture model likelihood. The pi sub k parameters are called the mixing weights. The theta sub k represent parameters for the kth component in the model. The f sub k define the distribution for the kth component. In PROC MBC, these distributions are either multivariate Gaussian or uniform. The big k value indicates the number of components in the model, and because you are using this for model-based clustering, this also represents the number of clusters. For the case you're considering, two or three clusters seem appropriate. Here is the PROC MBC syntax for fitting this model. There are three options that control the models that will be evaluated. The N clusters option specifies a list of values for the number of multivariate Gaussian clusters, two or three. The noise option specifies whether the model should include a uniform noise component. The cove struct option specifies the covariance structure to use in the model. You'll see more details about this shortly. Each element in these lists will be used in combination with the elements from the other lists, giving 16 models in all. The procedure uses expectation maximization, or EM, to find maximum likelihood estimates and chooses the best model as the model that has the best Bayesian information criterion, or BIC. The output statement directs the procedure to store information in the mycas.myscore output dataset. MyCAS is a CAS libref. This output dataset will contain the cluster assignments for each observation in the dataset. The output dataset will also contain weights, called posterior weights, that are the soft clustering values for each observation. Before you review the results, here's a little information about the covariance structures. The figures provide simple examples to illustrate some different types. Those three-letter shorthand names indicate how the covariance matrices in the multivariate Gaussian components share elements of their structure. The first letter is the volume constraint, indicating whether the different covariance matrices have E for equal volumes or V for variable volumes in each cluster. The second letter is the shape constraint. This constraint can also take the I value, meaning that the shape is isotropic or spherical, like the identity matrix. Finally, the third letter indicates the orientation constraint. If the orientation constraint is I, the covariance matrices are not rotated with respect to the coordinate axes. Now that you have fit the model, look at the model information for the selected model. You'll see information about the number of Gaussian clusters, the covariance structure, and whether the selected model includes a noise cluster. There is also other information about the selection and estimation process. The parameter estimates and mixing probability estimates describe the mixture model that was selected. The parameter estimates describe the mean and covariance of each Gaussian cluster. In the mixing estimates table, the numbering starts at 0 because this model did include a noise component. Component 0 is the noise component. As in the previous plot, the marker symbol and color indicate which cluster each point was assigned to. These results conform to your impression of two clusters, each with strong correlation and some background noise. The marker is determined by the max post variable in the output data set. You can also examine the soft clustering values, which are stored in the WT0, WT1, and WT2 variables in the output data set. In this plot, the color of the point is darker for stronger associations. When you look at the WT0 values, which indicate strength of association with the noise cluster, they are highest outside of the X shape. In areas where two clusters cross, the strength of association for any cluster is lower, producing gray areas. Here's a quick summary of what PROC MBC and the SAS Viya actions that support it provide. The purpose is to fit mixtures, particularly mixtures of multivariate Gaussians. The procedure can also model a uniform noise component. The output can include soft clustering information in addition to hard assignments. You can store your fitted models to apply to new data sets. You can access the Viya actions through several clients other than the SAS client. Thank you for watching this presentation. I hope you've enjoyed it.